It sounds so good. For what it's worth. It's just a sweet sound, yeah. Like the sweet man. Like it never gets old. It never gets old to God. But you're saying something because God's old.
God's got you wherever you are, knowing that that's not where you're going to be forever.
And it's all because of this one story that has the power to change the life of every human being who's ever lived and will ever live. The story of Jesus, this gospel, it's not a cotton candy gospel. It's a gospel that's forged through 2,000 years of people going through it and coming out the other side. It's a story that's been forged by people who've been through war, who've been through suffering, who've been through sorrow after sorrow after sorrow, and experienced the joy and the peace and the grace and the freedom and the life that God promises us. There are generations upon generations, and they're in heaven right now, and they're telling the tales. They're saying, you gotta hear what God did for me. One day we'll be there and we're going to tell the tales. Let me tell you my story. Tell me about yours. Oh my gosh, God did that for you. And we're going to see again. And here and now we've got these moments, morning by morning, day after day. It's a journey of simply trusting God. So the reason we're here is because it's always just been about the fact that God uses everyday, ordinary, broken people participate in the greatest story the world will ever know. And he invites you, and he invites me, to be a part of it. And there's a time to grieve, and there's a time to wait, and there's a time to run, and there's a time to fight. It's a season for all of you. God's going to have his way one way or another. We just need to trust him, so we're going to sing tonight. No matter where you are, maybe you invested in crypto or something like 20 years ago and you're just soaring right now, I don't know. Maybe it's just a miracle you're even here. Maybe you don't even know. Maybe tomorrow is just so frightening, it's hard to even think of. Maybe there's someone here and you can't handle the grief. You hear and you hurt, and the trauma's too much. And we're all people, everyone's going through something. We're gonna sing not just to God, we're gonna sing with each other. We're gonna join our voice, those on our right and our left. We're gonna sing for those who are going through it. We're gonna sing and rejoice for those who are flying high. But all together, God's gonna get the glory in this place. So you're ready tonight.
Thank you. anybody.
To fall so far, but I found heaven.
Come on. Sweet wine, all you have. off one quick moment and make sure that everyone had the opportunity to respond to who Jesus really is and respond by praying a simple prayer that accepts who he is and starts this whole journey of following him. Maybe you're here tonight. You've heard about Jesus, but never truly understood why his name is so powerful. Can I tell you tonight the reason that Jesus' name is so powerful? Because what he did on that cross for you and I means that we are now forgiven. We no longer have to be held back from shame from the past, but we can find freedom through the forgiveness that that name represents. Because of Jesus, yeah, be grateful that you're forgiven. No, I am. The reason that that name that we can sing about tonight, we have your song is so powerful, is because not only are we forgiven, but we understand we have a future. We can actually leave this place with great hope, knowing that God hasn't created anyone in this place by accident. He's designed you, he's created you, and he has something incredible for you here on this earth. And maybe greatest of all, the reason why Jesus' name is so powerful is that when we follow him, we encounter his grace and his love for every day of the journey. And that love is so strong, the Bible teaches us. It says in Romans 8:38 that there is nothing that can separate us from his love. And what that actually means for us in this room tonight is, regardless of if you're in the top, very back row, or the very front, or anywhere in between, there's nothing in life that you could have done that is so bad that would stop Jesus from loving you. There's no place that you might have found yourself that is too far away. Jesus knows everything about you and I, and he loves us and accepts us just the way that we are. But he also loves us too much to leave us the way he finds us, so he invites us on this journey. And it's a journey that is filled every morning with brand new mercy, brand new grace. And so tonight my question is, have you ever made a decision to accept that powerful name of Jesus? I just want to ask if everyone can close your eyes in this place, not because we want to do anything weird. I just want to take this moment for you to think honestly, where do you stand when it comes to Jesus? And I believe there's many people here tonight who can say, yes, Jamie, I've accepted him, I've prayed that prayer. That's incredible, but maybe you're here tonight. There's never been that specific moment where you decided to say yes to who God is and all that he has for you. I believe tonight could be that night for you. Or maybe you find yourself here tonight and at one stage you can say you're following Jesus, but for whatever reason, you've turned your back on that journey of doing life and being for Jesus. And I just want to remind you that Jesus has never turned his back on you. You've watched time and you turn back to him. You're not going to be confronted with a pointing finger, but with an open, welcoming, loving arms. So if you would love or you would like me to pray this prayer with him for you, it's a prayer of accepting Jesus and starting the journey following him. Just so you know what I'm praying for. I'm going to count to three, and if you want to do this, if you know this is your moment, why don't you lift up your hand and I'll lead you to the greatest prayer you could ever pray. All across this room, if that's you, why don't you raise your hand on 1, 2, 3, raise your hand if you want to commit your life. It's so incredible, thank you, I see so many hands and we don't want anyone to miss out on this. This is so good. All right, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to pray this prayer out really simply by my heart. I'm going to ask for this whole arena to repeat this after me as a big family, but especially if your hands are in the air. Say this after me, come on, let's pray. Say, Jesus, I thank you that you love me. I thank you that you died on the cross and you rose again for me. I'm sorry for the mistakes that I've made. Please forgive me. Come into my heart. Give me a brand new start. I thank you that you now live in me. And I'll follow you the rest of my days. Amen. Amen. Come on, if you raise your hand, if you pray that prayer, would you talk to me, Amy, tonight? Get a hold of God's word.